just litter the UFC roster across the board.
And oftentimes his opponents will say he doesn't really do anything special, but he does everything at a plus level, and he believes he'll have a lot of advantages in this matchup tonight. Well, there is no denying this man's striking credentials. Prevailing wisdom is he's going to try to keep this fight standing tonight.
He has to. You know, this is what got him to the show. It was being able to use the hands to set up the kicks. We all talk about the high-level boxing background of this young man, but as he's developed great knees.
Yeah.
He's developed great timing, great counter skills, and also the beautiful right high kick. The right high kick is something he hides very well as he follows with a jab, right hand, left hook. High kick comes over the top, and he can put you to sleep.
No doubt about it. He will try to put on a striking clinic once again here tonight. And now our tail of the tape for this lightweight scrap. So a more than 5-year gap between these two fighters when it comes to the age, with similar height and the same reach. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC lightweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 23 wins, 7 losses. He stands 5'8" tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of Boca Raton, Florida, Iron Michael Chandler! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a kickboxer holding a professional record of 15 wins, 1 loss. He stands 5'7" tall, weighing in at 154 pounds. Fighting out of Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, the Assassin. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Dan Mergliotta.
Dan Mergliotta, your referee.
You ready? You ready?
So he lost his last fight by devastating knockout. So the question beckons as round one gets underway here. Can he regain the momentum that saw him vault into contention not all that long ago? A lot of people believe he can. We will find out here in short order. Oh! And now he goes with the combination of punches to the head. Potentially some concussive damage there.
I mean, absolutely concussive damage. Landing all those strikes to the head. He's very accurate, he's very fast, and he has a real confidence every time he throws his punches.
Bleeding from his cheek now.
Oh! Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice.
Oh! Oh! He's got him hurt here.
Double leg shot.
Oh, he slams him to the ground. 3 minutes in our opening round. Recovery, man. Right back to his feet. That is a huge shot there, DC. I'm not sure how he stayed upright.
I mean, when you get hit with a shot like that, to stay standing, show, and talk, you're tough.
Whoa!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh, he might be out. Look at that, he leapt up and landed the diving punch to the head.
Oh, he got him hurt bad!
All right, he's sort of hanging out here unguarded, DC. Not sure if he's trying to bait him in or what, but not great body language here.
Now look at him jumping in to try to get the finish.
Really timing his shots nicely. Good tempo, very accurate, finding the range with relative ease.
Yeah, he's doing a great job of really overwhelming his opponent with activity.
And they separate. And both guys really throwing with authority. Whoa!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
1 minute, 60 seconds. Beautiful movement, hip work on the ground here. Just outstanding with the transition.
He is not staying in one place on the ground. That's very important.
Yes. 30 seconds now to go in round one.
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh, he might be out. So that's the end of the round. Pretty significant damage done in that round. Cut on the cheek, sustained there from that strike. Now the cut man's got to get in there and close that thing up. Better to be below the eye than above it, sure. But nonetheless, this could be a factor now moving forward. Result for him here tonight as he gets the win by way of knockout, and that's about as good a one-strike finish as we've seen here in the UFC in recent memory. I'm not even sure the opponent saw it coming, so a big, big win for him here tonight. All right, we'll take a look back at the highlights. You know we're going to find that nasty head kick somewhere in this highlight rip. Just an incredible result for him here tonight.
A very nice head kick to finish the fight, but don't ignore all the work he did with his hands. And give credit to the opponent. The opponent was in there every step of the way. And in order to get a fight of the night like you got tonight, both guys have to be willing to participate.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta is going to stop this contest at 51 seconds of round number two. Declaring the winner by knockout, the Assassin.
Oh, there he is after a huge knockout win tonight. You going to the after party or what?
I mean, I'm heading over there right now, John. I'm asking the producers, how soon can I get up? This is going to be a party over there. Not only because of the knockout, but that extra bonus check he's going to be carrying to the club tonight.